Hi everyone, I'm Sporty and this is Ange and we're from Mostly Mindful,
where we encourage you to buy less, do more and live sustainably and simply in the city.
Today's video is going to be about our purchase wins. We did purchase fails a few weeks ago, so we thought we'd follow up with this one. So let's do it.
Let's dive in. We'll take you around to show you all the things that we are happiest with.
Cool.
Come on. So our first purchase win, this is Florrie Bessie Bly. We named after a few female adventurers. We hadn't had a car in about, I think, around about 12 years. We didn't need one because we were in town. And when we made the decision at the end of 2020, towards the end of 2020, to move out to a farm for a while, we decided that we'd need a car. Being a couple of girls, we drove Florrie around the block and said, yes, we'll take her without having her checked or whatever. And she has not let us down. She's just such an amazing little car. She's roomy. She's great for camping. We can fold the seats down. You can fit our bicycles in there. We actually hoped that we'd be able to sleep in her, but unfortunately, she's just a little bit too short for that. But she's a super comfy ride and we absolutely love her.
What kind of car is she, Ange?
Oh, good point, Sporty. She's a Fiat Cubo, which funny enough, we didn't even know this make existed until we saw her on the showroom floor and we were instantly smitten. We think that she's just the loveliest little car ever. She's probably not the fastest car, but she's a comfy drive, not expensive on petrol. She's a keeper.
Okay, so this is the item that we love the most. In fact, he's the winner of our purchase wins, number one, and that's Blendobi. He's our very loyal and trusted blender who's been with us for a number of years. The readers that read our blog will know of him because he's got his own blog post. He's even in our logo. We love him so much. So he traveled with us when we went sort of semi-nomadic, and he does smoothies every day. He can even grind coffee beans and stuff like that. Apparently he makes nut butters, which we haven't tried yet, even though we've had him for years. And also makes nut milks and those kind of things. So he's super versatile, and yeah, he just keeps on trucking. I think we've had to replace one part, and that's all. So, yay, Blendobi!
We love Blendobi. Next up in our purchase wins is Oscar the juicer. We only got Oscar literally a couple of weeks ago. He's a new to us buy. We bought him from our friends who are relocating to Costa Rica, and we feel super fortunate because we got him at such a great price, and these guys are pretty expensive if you buy them new. We bought him because Sporty in particular has to be on a juice cleanse at the moment, and Oscar's is the best way to do that. He's quiet, he's what you call a cold press juicer, so he doesn't really shred the vegetables to bits. He takes them very carefully through, but he's actually fast about it as well. It sounds like he's crunching.
when you're juicing with him. He's easy to clean, and so far it's only been a couple of weeks, but we are absolutely smitten, and him and Blendobe get on really well, which is also awesome. And another one of our real purchase wins is the Sprout Farm over here. Also, one of those things that is super easy to use, really didn't cost a lot, and requires very little sort of maintenance and whatever. Obviously, it's jars and a rack. I mean, it provides us sprouts on a very regular basis, nothing in there at the moment because we're in between batches. But it basically, depending on the seed you use, you could sprout yourself something every 2 or 3 days. And when I'm sprouting regularly, then I rotate. So basically we're in sprouts the whole time. And you can vary them, different flavors, all sorts of wonderful things, and the nutrition benefit is sky high. So purchase win, definitely, for the win.
The chef in the family loves them because they're great addition to salads. So thanks to Sporty for being the sprout farmer.
Okay, this is a bit of a surprising win. We bought this I think round about the same time that we bought Flurry. We just moved to the farm and we needed a washing machine, but we were also on a bit of a budget. So we opted for a twin tub rather than the more expensive front loader. And we figured since we're hippies, we don't care about the extra work. And it's actually more environmentally friendly because you can manage better how much water you use. But when it arrived, we were a little bit worried, me in particular, because it's such a toy. It's really light. You can just pick it up by yourself. Either one of us can just pick it and move it around very easily. And I thought, oh no, we've made a purchase fail. But in fact, this little machine works like a bomb, and it also it spins better than the front loaders that we've had. We're actually planning to make a video just for the washing machine because it's really an environmentally friendly little gem. But suffice to say, if you're looking for something that's cost effective, works like a charm, we give this one the thumbs up.
Hello everyone. So these two things are absolute purchase wins, the floor desk and the yoga chair. So the floor desk, we basically just bought as a sort of what we call a tide me over. It was supposed to be a temporary thing because it was really cheap. I mean, crazy cheap. I think it was like 200 Rand. But it's really served us so well. The legs fold in, this thing folds flat, and you can just stack it up against a wall somewhere or something. And obviously you can just adjust the position. And this thing's also adjustable, so it can be higher or lower depending on how you like to work. And then the yoga chair, this was also quite a surprise because we went to an ashram for a couple of weeks some years back, and we bought these there just for the sessions because you sit for long periods of time. So this was very comfortable. And we thought this would be sort of a once-off buy and we wouldn't really use them again. And funnily enough, we've actually used them a crazy amount, like obviously now, you know, for work. And then we've even taken them camping and we obviously still use them for courses and things like that. And for Zoom calls, you know, if you're attending a long Zoom call, this is great. So yeah, two great purchase wins.
And those chairs were also super cheap, if I remember correctly.
Yeah, something in Indian currency, but I just can't remember what.
Yeah. Wins.
Total wins. Okay, so in closing, I just asked Ange what the qualities are of the wins or the purchase wins that we've listed here. And I mean, besides them all working and serving us well and not breaking, there isn't really, like from a price perspective, there isn't really a commonality, because some of the things are quite expensive, like cars and juices. But then, you know, the desk and the chair and that kind of thing were really cheap. And we'll probably have the desk for a long time, and the chair we've had for years.
Yeah, exactly. And we didn't pay that much for the sprouting kit either. But it's basically what they provide us. We're using these items every single day. And I think that's the key when you live in a sort of minimalist or simple lifestyle, is that you are making regular use out of the things that you have in your home. Otherwise, what's the point, really? And I mean, Blendobi, we've used him, I'd say, every single day, barring for that period when we looked after the off-grid permaculture farm where we weren't allowed to use him, which was literally, it was less than a month.
Yeah, that's true.
But in 6 years, we've used him every day, sometimes multiple times a day. I don't know. Let us know in the comments if you've got purchase wins. We've all had purchase fails and, you know, impulse buys and things. But we've also got things that were really great buys. So let us know in the comments what yours were. They're down here somewhere, the comments.
And subscribe and like and notification bells.
All those thingies.
So we can be in front of more like-minded people like you.
Nice.
Bye.
Hippie vibes from Cape Town. Bye.
Okay, so you're going to start this time.
No, I started last time, and then you can remember to say live simply or sustainable.
Well, then you do the whole thing.
No, I'm not doing the whole thing. You introduce
they
us.
They can't see our faces. We're in shade.
We've said that.
Hi!
Again, that's okay.
Let's try. Okay, go.
No, you must go. You have to say
that. I won't remember.
Just say that you're sporty and I'm Edge.
Is it the same way? Hi everyone, I'm Sporty and this is Ange, and we're from Mostly Mindful,
where we teach you to... I can't remember what.
You can't see the stuff behind me, eh?
You mean the pile of clutter that I haven't eco-bricked? No, we can't see that, thank goodness.
Oops. Oh yeah, of course that's loose. Oh, careful, don't drop that on your feet. Eh?
Never mind, my feet are going to break Blendobi.
I love my Oscar. My Oscar.
Okay.
Okay. Good.
Okay. Good. Thanks. Babe. And same for everything else. Smoking plain cigarettes. Quit the smokes.